Okay, we're gonna work on printing one of the test prints. We'll print this four digit with the lid, and I'll show you how to set up the print. We're gonna download the four digit with lid STL file. I'll download the SCAD file actually too, just to show you. I'll grab them and I'll copy them over to my folder. To edit the SCAD file, you can download OpenSCAD. So I'm gonna open up this SCAD file and show you how it renders here. You can edit the file right here in OpenSCAD, or you can edit it in your favorite editor, because all I want to do is add a third layer of white on the face. And I remember where that happens, right here. Actually, it's just the diffuser height I need to change in this case. So I'm going to make it three layers instead of two, so 0.28 times three is 369.84. Okay, so now we got four layers. And so you don't have to do this at all to print the STL file that's there. I just wanted to add another layer to mine, and now I want to make sure they are at the same height. Now that I have three layers on the diffuser, that my lid is a different height here than the diffuser, and it won't rest the same way. So here where the back lid gets moved, I'm gonna add an extra two, just to test it first, 0.28. And now it should be equal. Done. Okay, so I'm going to close the other. I've saved that file to update it. Now I'm going to render it with the second button here, render. Now we can confirm they're the same height. And you can see the clear layers you can't see through anymore in the render. Everything else looks nice. So we're going to save it as an STL file. And I'll save it differently. And then I will close this. So now I have two STL files with the thicker and thinner lids and diffusers. I'm going to open up Cura now and set up my print. In the meantime, I'm going to warm up my print bed. Change the filament. Creality White Hyper Series filament first, which is a little bit translucent, so it lets the light through. And then I'm going to fill the rest with probably a black PLA plus. So here in Cura, I have set up 0.28 coarse PLA plus profile. And I'll walk you through some of the important changes that I made there. I'm going to open up that file that we just made, the new file. It is upside down, so I'm going to flip it. And at first we'll just slice it just to test. I think that it's better to print it this direction for my printer. I've set my Z seam to be on the left side, so I specify it instead of it being random. And this makes it so that on the back of the clock, we don't have this kind of seam right there. Instead, it'll be at a corner. And if you had a very thick diffuser, you might want to add more layers so that you don't get an infill. I use a line top and bottom pattern, so it just does straight lines, and then I ensure the direction of the lines by looking at a preview is vertical first, so it is making less force on the long direction of the print here. I'm gonna add or two more layers of border here, because I got a little bit of peeling last time. 10% cubic infill, which you can see, and I have it aligned as well at zero, so that it has these vertical infill directions, so that the cross top layer can fit very nicely on top of them. I think this is probably too much infill. You might not need any, but this makes a very nice top. I'm going to use a 210 degree with a 215, just because of what I know my printer likes, and a 60 degree print bed. And I found that the shrinkage factor made it a little hard to fit everything in tightly, so I'm going to go back to 100%. print speed I set pretty fast to 220 because it does work, and on my Creality Ender 3 SE. My retraction, I don't know if it's perfect, but it's working okay. There's a little bit of stringing. I'm gonna change that to within infill because I don't want it to go through the light paths, which it seems to be doing lately. The fan is on, there's no support. I got a brim and I'm gonna make it about 13 or 14 wide. The brim margin was a little too big last time, so I'm gonna go more like this because there was a big gap last time that I think led to part of the peeling up and the rounding. So it's looking quite good. You can see everything's in order. It's gonna be 8 hours and 39 minutes. I'm gonna add, you can see that on the, if I just go to here and after I click this, I can press up and down to cycle through the layers. So I can see the first three layers are gonna be the white. And then the fourth layer is when I want it to change to black. And so I'm gonna add an extension, a post-processing modified G code. I'm gonna add a script called pause at height. I'm gonna pause at the third layer. When the third layer is done, this is gonna have the effect of pausing and then letting me change to black filament. I'm gonna keep the motors engaged and I'm gonna set my method to OctoPrint because I have OctoPrint running on my Raspberry Pi, which is connected to my printer. You don't have to have that, but I have it. And in order to pause and restart correctly, I need to set this method here. But if you just want to pause and restart on your machine, you could leave that how it was. These should all be good. I'm going to have it retract 20 millimeters once it's done, and I'm going to have it beep. I'm going to save my profile. I'm almost ready to print, so I'm just going to change my filament. Okay, I had a black filament in there before, so I'm going to open up OctoPrint and extrude some of the filament to get rid of that black. Okay, so I'm going to open up OctoPrint, and this is running on a Raspberry Pi that's turned on, and my printer's turned on. Printer's warmed up already. I'm going to extrude a bunch of filament that's black or gray or increasingly white from my print head. Camera nicely here. I've got a nice textured print bed here. I forget if this was the stock. Use some alcohol swab there to clean it off. And other than that, I think we're pretty much ready to go here. So I will flip back to Cura. We're gonna preview one last time. And now we have a print with OctoPrint button. So we're gonna engage print with OctoPrint. Gonna do its thing, and I'll show you the filament change when it pauses after the third layer, as we've set up right here. Successfully started the brim, looks okay to me, so we'll tune back in if there's any problems or if otherwise once the first three layers are done. Kind of a lot of string in here, but it's not going to be a big deal. Kind of got a weird extra poop coming out of the extruder that I'm trying to clean up before the hot end gets there. But it's hard. I cleaned that up a little bit. That strainness, and I cleaned up the back there, so now I'm gonna just let it go.
Soon it'll be a clock like you.
It's all done. Here, put together.